Hey everybody, it's Shu. We're back for another Golden Grin solo stealth on one down. I said before, when we did a previous run, that things went pretty easily, and I'd try to get a run that had a little more adversity, so we're hoping to run into that now. We're hoping to get some spawns that aren't as lucky, so we can show what it looks like when not everything goes your way, and how you'd crawl out of that. Still going with the same setup.
Excellent. Time to put it to the test.
Let's see how things go.
You're in civilian mode. No guns, no masks.
This was captured with the new update on Shadowplay, which I'm really impressed by. I'm not seeing any performance hits from it. It feels easier to use than the old one. Everything just feels really just smooth. I like it. Okay, so we see the blue bottle. We're checking to see if we get the blue bottle over here. And we don't. Alright, so the first thing to go wrong. That's good for us for this video. Okay, it looks like the blue bottle's upstairs. Now we're checking to see what are our routes to get upstairs. Okay, we've got those. Alright, we've got two sets of stairs outside to get to it. So, yeah, we don't have an ideal drink spawn, but we have a way to get to it. So this might be good for the video. This is already one thing that's gone wrong.
See that guitar case over there?
And just like before, I'm gonna leave the sleeping gas behind. It's easier to get to the back area without masking up first. Much safer, you don't have to make as many dangerous runs. And since we'll be going back through that area anyway, it'll be safer to get the sleeping gas then. Okay, so this guy's blocking our way. We're gonna have to wait for him to leave. This is one of the reasons that it's good not to mask up. If I was masking up, I'd be rushing to get out of the casino floor and out here, and I'd be running straight into this guy. Doesn't seem to want to move. I've never seen a stationary guard here, so I don't think he's stationary, but maybe he is? A normal guard would have moved from his patrol by now, I think. If there's a stationary guard blocking our path on our most used way, yeah, we're going to slink past him. But yeah, if he's blocking our path this whole time, that'll be good for this, too. Just to show another thing that's gone wrong and how to handle it. We can slink past him now when we're unmasked, but on future runs, we're going to have to figure out a way to get past him. We're going to have to kill him, or we're going to have to start using the right side of the map. And killing him's going to be hard, because where he was under a camera. We might have to use the judge to catapult him out of view. Okay, I saw the civilian through the bookcase. As I was grabbing this, you can still sort of see her to the left. Oh, she's almost seeing me. Gotta duck out of here. Obnoxious. Sixth sense is so useful. Oh, come on, really? Alright, so she's blocking our path, so we're gonna try and grab a couple others that are safe right now. If you get behind this cart, the camera to the right won't catch you. Okay, she's moving from that spot, so we're gonna go back there now. And that's a handy thing to do. Once you're holding your key to do an objective, you can still move your head a little bit. You can use that to look out for things that might be coming at you. Even when it feels like you've reached the end of it, you can slowly drag your view out just a little more.
Now find a scanner,
and that can be really helpful. Okay.
I'll find that vent.
So that was a little obnoxious, but we got it done. Let's see. For the sake of this video, it'd actually be nice if we get a room in the 150s, because that's harder to do.
153.
All right.
Its vent goes right to the security center.
The 150s are harder to do because you have to get across part of the casino floor to get out there, where with the 100 block hotels, you can just go up the stairs and take a little turn. since we're in here, we're gonna start the drill, and then we'll come back to it later. As I've said in the previous video, the drill in that room can't break, so might as well just start it so that when we come back and need what's in the safe later, it's just waiting for us. Okay, so that guy is, alright, that guy is stationary. He's still there, that's crazy. We're gonna have to get rid of him. We need to figure out a way. Alright, I think we can get the angle on this and catapult him. Okay, just outside camera range. Hopefully nobody comes and sees us while we're doing this.
This is a test.
Okay, now we're gonna have to move this body. So that's interesting. I've actually never seen a stationary guard in that spot before. And yeah, there was no way we could leave him where he is. So already we've had to struggle with a little bit of adversity compared to that easy, easy run we had before. Sleeping gas. Come on, we're here.
Thank you. A camera.
Oh, and one shot again. Okay. So briefcase is here because we put Heartbreaker Annie in here. Remember it. It's one of the reasons I like using that as a little pit stop. Not only is it fairly safe and easy to get to the reception area, but it means you can pick up one of the digits you'll need later while you're on the way. This is what I'm talking about before, like where you interact with an objective and then pull your view down. Handy for things like looping cameras so you can see if anybody's coming at you. Okay. Ooh. Almost walked right into that. And into that. Okay. Let's get to the back area. And see, yeah, we have to use this route a lot, so if that guard was still there, we'd end up having to use the other side. And that would involve a lot of crisscrossing. That guy, I wanted rushed down because I caught his outline behind the camera when I was still around the corner and realized I only had a limited window to get around that corner and kill him before he got back into camera view. Taking him out right now ensures that it's one less person that's going to be in the back area. Makes it safer for us to operate. I think that was the last of my body bags, so I'm gonna fill up on the wrapping can be found in the designated area. Gives me something to do while we're waiting for the gamble. Okay, the white shirt. White shirt is on our side that we've deployed our stuff and we've been using. That is lucky, but all things considered, we've had some things that have not gone our way, so I think this is a decent run for adversity's sake so far. We're gonna have. We know that his drink is in the upstairs bar because of the recon we already did. So we're gonna go out here and try to get up one of the staircases. You could also get there from the casino floor upstairs. You could use like the staircase to the apartments, get up here, and then go in. But this feels a little safer.
Secured.
Got this area clear right now. We'll use it to get the drink spiked. Get into the women's room. And from the last time, we learned that hiding over in that other spot while safe catapults the body with the judge into a spot that might still be seen. So we're gonna hide over here in case he comes into the ladies' room.
Take a nice long drink, pal. Get after him and wait for your chance.
Okay, so he's not coming into the ladies' room, he's going outside. That's another random thing that went wrong, so this is pretty good for the sake of this video. Basically, your only real recourse is to just kill him and get going. You could take him as a hostage, but goodness. Especially out here, that's way too risky. Better to just take the body bag and run. Alright, and so it's at 153. I'm going to be going outside again, because that's going to be the safest way to get up there, rather than trying to traverse the casino floor where there's more guards. But, looks like that's a civilian. But that is definitely a guard up there. Okay, so there's the guard there. We probably could get behind him, but we don't know where the civilian is and what his path is going to be, so let's take this carefully. Okay, so there's the civilian. Right now we have to wait. Security guard. Well, it looks like civilian is coming right at us. The guard is leaving, but we can't take advantage of it right now until the civilian clears. Alright, looks like alright, we have an opening now. Now we have to get across only a really small part of the casino floor rather than that full length to our right.
Now look for a vent and get that gas.
153. Okay, it's the right. Or left, sorry.
It worked! The guards and security are sleeping like babies.
Alright, so we've already got the hardest stuff done, despite a bunch of the curveballs that they've thrown us. Now we're gonna go across a little length of the floor again to get out to the stairs.
A security guard.
And that guard that we pointed out, that's one reason we don't want to use the casino floor if we can help it. So now that the cameras are turned off, we just need two numbers from the back. One of them we've already drilled for. The other is going to be in the locker room. So the hardest part of this is already done. There's the locker room. Let's look for that briefcase.
Security guard.
The cameras are off, so we could kill this guy, but we've already spent two pagers, and we'll probably have to spend one more when the guy routes to our cache, when we're taking it out. So I don't want to push up against four pagers if I can help it. Just waiting a few seconds, we can do this safely. Oop. Okay, he's on the move.
Nice. Security chief's number. He won't be happy to lose.
Okay, he's got to be behind that pillar.
A security guard.
This is where the last number was, because we already started that drill.
Got it. The casino manager's code. Three digits. Outstanding. Now head to the vault and try them out.
Now all we need to do is get in there, disable the lasers, and start bagging and moving loot. The dentist loot will be behind a set of lasers, but it's not that hard to get past.
The vault of the Grin Security Center. Head there.
Just wait. these little timers on end game things are sort of a challenge to make sure that you didn't fuck up and that you're not trying to race past it. Like, for example, it's to make sure that you didn't run out of body bags and have to leave bodies somewhere that eventually a guard will discover them. The longer it makes you wait, the more chances it gives the guards to path into mistakes. And this is sort of the insurance for that. It's a way of saying, alright, did you really get it? Or are you just trying to bullshit past it and hope you can get the loot and get out before it goes loud? Alright, about 10 seconds left.
Right, the numbers for the code are... 0... 5...
There we go. And after that, it's just moving a bunch of bags, so I'm gonna leave you here with this on fast forward and enjoy the music of Albert Ayler. This song is called New Ghosts. Thanks.
The night and day will pass away, pass away. But love will always be. Night and day will pass away.